Hello students, in this class I am going to discuss about the animal tissue culture. The animal tissue culture is an important aspect of any biotechnological field it is necessary for the culturing of animal cells in artificial medium. And the cultured animal cells are used in the field of recombinant DNA technology, genetic manipulations and the variety of industrial processes with economical potentials. In production of vaccines, monoclonal antibody, pharmaceutical drugs, cancer research, etc., these animal cell and tissue culture is very much necessary. The egg cells are used for the manipulation of superior livestock through cloning or superior embryonic cells and the transformation of cultural cells leading to the production of transgenic animals. These are all the aspects of animal tissue culture system. So the animal cells can grow in a simple glass or plastic containers and which contains the nutritive media, but they grow only to the limited generations. In these bottles or petri dishes, these are made up of glass or plastics. In these vessels, which contains the liquid media, inside this media the animal cells are cultured. And these cells exhibit the contact inhibition. That means when the cells grow and it reaches at the surface of the glass vessels, their growth are stopped. And this is known as the contact inhibition. The cell cultured in vitro differs from those in vivo conditions. There is an absence of cell-cell interaction and cell matrix interaction, and there is a lack of 3D architectural appearance and the change of hormonal and nutritional environment. So to culture in a in vitro condition of animal cells, we have to provide the nutrient in this condition. And the maintenance of growth of the cells under laboratory condition in suitable culture media is known as the primary cell culture. And these cells are dissociated from tissues by mechanical means and by enzymatic digestion using the proteolytic enzymes. This is the machine by which the cells are dissociated from tissues by mechanical means. The cells can grow as adherent cells, which are known as the anchorage dependent, or as a suspension cell culture, which are known as the anchorage independent. In case of adherent cells, the cells are growing inside the solid surface, and in the suspension culture, they are growing as the liquid maintenance media. The primary culture is subculture in a fresh media to establish the secondary cultures, which is known as cell lines, and generally with the particular attributes. The cell lines are two types. One is the finite cell lines, which have a limited lifespan, and the continuous cell lines, which grows continuously and in the in vitro condition to give rise to the cell line. For a successful cell culture in the in vitro type, conditions needs to be maintained. These are special incubator. A special incubator is needed where the level of oxygen, carbon dioxide, temperatures and humidity are maintained. And the synthetic media, which contains the vitamin, amino acid, fetal serum. And this synthetic media is also required for the animal cell culture. The culture media is prepared in the such a way that it provides the optimum condition of factors like pH, osmotic pressure, etc., and it should contain the chemical constituent which the cells of tissue are incapable of synthesizing. Generally, the media is a mixture of inorganic salts and other nutrients capable of sustaining cells in culture, such as amino acids, fatty acids, sugar, ions, trace elements, vitamins, cofactors. The glucose is added as energy source. Its concentration varies depending on the requirement of cell culture. The phenaldehyde is added as a pH indicator of the medium. On change of the pH, the phenaldehyde changes color. There are two types of media. One is natural media, another one is synthetic media. The natural media are the natural sources used in the form of coagulant, such as plasma clot, a serum. It is an important source of various amino acids, hormones, lipids, vitamins, polyamines, and salts containing ions such as calcium, ferrous, ferric, potassium. And it also contains the growth factors which promotes the cell proliferation, cell attachment, and adhesion factors. The serum is obtained from the human adult blood, placental cord blood, and horse blood, calf blood, etc. The tissue extract, extract of tissue are such as embryo extract, liver extract, spleen, leukocyte, tumor, bone marrow. These are extracted to obtain the culture tissue extract. And other biological fluids such as coconut water, amniotic fluid, pleural fluid, insect hemolymph serum. These are all used as the natural medium. The synthetic media are prepared artificially by adding several organic and inorganic nutrients, vitamins, salts, serum proteins, carbohydrate, cofactors. And synthetic media are of two types. One is containing serum, another one is serum-free media. The examples are minimal extensional media, RPMI media, CMRL media, etc. The advantages of serum in culture media are serum binds to the binds and neutralizes the toxins, and serum also contains the complete set of essential growth factors, hormones, attachment and spreading factors, and binding and transport proteins. It contains the protease inhibitor, it increases the buffering capacity, and it also provides the trace elements. So these serum contains many factors conductive for cell growth and multiplication. The disadvantage of serum in culture media are it is not chemically defined, and therefore its composition varies a lot. It is sometimes source of contamination by viruses, mycoplasma, and prions, and it increases the difficulties and cost of downstream processing. It is also most expensive component of the culture media. In short, serum composition is undefined, may be contaminated, and the culture and downstream processing besides being expensive. The other conditions of a media are pH. The media optimum pH should be between 7 and 7.4, and the regulation of pH is done using the variety of buffering system, and most media use a bicarbonate CO2 system as the component, hence the use of CO2 incubators. And osmolality, a change in osmolality can affect the cell growth and function. To maintain the optimum osmolality, the cell should be cultured around at 300 milliosmolarity, and the temperature should be at 37 degrees centigrade. So these are the applications of the animal cell culture. These animal cell cultures have the wide application in research and development purpose, and these are the production of antivirus and antiviral and vaccines, the cancer research and the cell fusion techniques, the genetic manipulation, the production of monoclonal antibodies, the production of pharmaceutical drugs, chromosome analysis and of cell derived from womb, and the study of the effects of toxins and pollutants. These are used for the production of artificial skin and the study and function of nerve cells. So students, this is the culture of animal cell culture medium and applications of animal cell culture media, animal cell culture. And we also have seen that these animal cell culture is used for the production of antibodies. In this case, the monoclonal antibodies are produced from the mice immunized with antigen, and these monoclonal antibodies have various roles in case of immunity development and identification of antigens. And these animal cell culture is very much used for the cloning. And students, in this section I have completed the animal cell culture and its application. So please go through this slide, and if you have any doubts, you can contact me later. Thank you.